Senate Blue Ribbon Committee Chairman Richard Gordon has formally asked the National Bureau of Investigation's help in locating Farmaly Pharmaceuticals Corporation Executive Grizel Grace Mago, who has been incommunicado to the Blue Ribbon panel since Sunday. During last Friday's committee hearing, Mago admitted that Farmaly has swindled the government on its procured face masks, face shields, and other supplies, which some senators place at around 12 billion pesos. Also during the hearing, Mago promised to get back to the panel on its offered protective custody.
The Blue Ribbon has not been able to reach her. Nakabarin ako na baka masaktan yung bata. I have also enlisted the help of the Sisters of St. Paul's. I think I can say that. And they have been trying to reach her as well.
Gordon fears parties linked to the Farmaly deal may hurt Mago. The last information he received, Mago being guarded in a house full of bodyguards. Senator Risa Ontiveros appeals to Mago to communicate to her office if she needs any form of assistance.
Patuloy yung aming pag-reach out sa kanya, pati sa pamamagitan ninyo sa media at sa social media, syempre.
Senator Panfilo Lacson says they also received information Farmaly officials are actually receiving threats through text and phone calls since the upper chamber started its probe. Lacson remains hopeful Mago will still appear on Thursday. But Lacson believes Mago's absence, if ever, will not totally affect the proceedings given her previous statements made under oath.
So far naman kasi nakapag-testify na siya at saka matibay naman yung kanyang testimonya.
On Monday, Farmaly Executive Lin Con-ong has sent a handwritten note to the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee, turning down the panel's offer to hear his version of Farmaly's dealings with the government through an executive session. Ong's newly hired counsel, Ferdinand Topacio, says his client never offered to appear before a closed session and accuses some senators of unfairly pinning down Ong to the point of already violating his rights. Topacio says they will decide if Ong should still participate at the Senate probe.
We are reconsidering that because this is not a fair forum. This is a kangaroo forum. The Blue Ribbon, not all, but some members of the Blue Ribbon Committee are not out to get the truth. They are out for blood.
Ong, who remains under the Senate custody, was supposed to be transferred to the Pasay City Jail. The move was deferred because of Ong's reported intention to appear in an executive session. Topacio says they will exhaust all legal actions to block any transfers.
Ang Senado is not above the law. It is not immune to legal processes. It is not immune to criminal cases.
But Senator Gordon is unfazed by Topacio's pronouncements.
Nanakot na sila, no? Sige, okay lang. Do your best, Ferdy. Yung mga talaga wala ibubuga na nanakot.
Senate President Vicente Soto III cautions Topacio against calling the Senate names or threatening the institution. The senators believe they already have strong evidence that would prove the government's transactions with Farmaly were anomalous. The office of the president vows to look into Mago's allegations. But for the president's spokesperson, there's not much in Mago's testimonies.
Ang tanong po, tatayo ba ho yung ganyang testimonya? Tignan po natin. Kinakailangan po kasi yan, masubstantiate.
The Blue Ribbon Committee will hold its 10th hearing on the Farmaly deal on Thursday. Sharian Torres, ABS-CBN News.